Joining us right now is former special assistant to President Trump, former press secretary to Vice President Mike Pence, Marc Lotter is here. Marc, good to see you.
Thank you for having me.
Thank you so much for joining the conversation. What do you make of all of this?
It's not surprising. I mean, the Clintons have been lying to the American people for decades now. They actually, remember, if you'll recall, tried to front load the primaries in 2008 to guarantee the nomination to Hillary Clinton back then, and it backfired on them. And so they've been playing these kinds of games. I mean, let's be honest here. They're the most dishonest name in politics since Nixon.
But Marc, where is the accountability? I mean, the president was on with the Ingram angle last night, Laura Ingram, and he weighed in on the scandal. Here's what he had to say. I got to ask you about this. Listen to this.
That is a big story, what you're saying. It's illegal, number one, and it's really very unfair to Bernie Sanders. I'm not a Bernie Sanders fan, but that was, I thought that was terrible.
So the issue here, in my view, is when you look at all of the tweeting from the president, he says, where is the Justice Department? How come the Justice Department is not investigating what we know was lawlessness, not necessarily here, but with the $140 million that could be considered treason that she got after selling uranium, so many other things. How come the president has to ask the Justice Department to look at what's clearly lawlessness?
Well, you have a delicate balance there between directing the Justice Department to launch into criminal investigations and how that all plays out. Obviously, the president's speaking his mind. I think he speaks the mind of the American people on this with a lot of questions. And we have to have faith in the justice system that they will take a look at these issues, like you mentioned, with Uranium One, with potential shifting of campaign funding. I mean, really what Donna Brazile was admitting was that they were fundraising for state and other parties that was all being funneled back to Hillary's campaign, which was then used to fit, you know, to fund the fake dossier and the peddling
of
that kind
of
trash. Well, it's not necessarily illegal. I'm not a lawyer, so I can't say that. But what I could say is that when you look at the funding of the fake dossier, hiring of foreign agents through intermediaries, I mean, those are some serious issues that need to be taken a look at.
The funding of the dossier, I don't believe it was disclosed on the campaign finance forms. That is a crime.
That's illegal.
And this was kind of lost this week because of this horrific terror attack here in New York City. But Hillary Clinton was on The Daily Show earlier this week and actually talked at length about the funding of this dossier. And she essentially said, well, the dossier, the lawyer representing the Clinton campaign paid Fusion GPS, and she basically said, well, he knows what's legal. What I'm talking, she's accusing the Trump campaign of doing something illegal, but essentially fesses up to this dossier and says, well, putting together opposition research is not illegal. And it was kind of astonishing to the lengths that she went to talk about this, because it could be, we don't know any details. I mean, it looks like collusion from the outside.
Yes, it does.
But the fact that she's talking about it, she's asking for the Justice Department to look into it. And quite frankly, they're asking for Robert Mueller to look into it. And let's hope that happens.
Got it. Right.
Yeah, I think that it's important to note that everyone needs to understand that with the Democrats, they have this whole super delegate system as well. And so they were really worried about that, because you even had the nurses union talking about how they were going to walk out. I mean, there were a lot of underpinnings that were happening during the convention that really was impacting sort of the Clinton campaign, Debbie Wasserman Schultz. I mean, Bernie Sanders said consistently the cards were stacked against him. So he saw this happening. I mean, the party knew what was going on.
We all knew it while it was going on.
Oh, everyone yeah, could clearly see exactly. It. They talked about it. The president talked about it. I mean, Bernie Sanders was talking about how the system was stacked against him.
Yeah.
Little did he know how much it was stacked, and it was stacked against him from the inside, which is a serious problem. It's a problem for the Democrats, and it's a problem for the Clintons.
It's incredible to me the push against this president from within his own government, and that's what I'm talking about in terms of the FBI and the Department of Justice. But then there's everybody else. I mean, the media.